Our memories of prep were Father Murphy. And he was just your connection to Fairfield Prep. That just never went away. He was here when the school started. And he was just the foundation. And everybody needs a foundation. And whenever you went back to prep, who was there? Father Murphy.
He was such a beautiful person. I mean, small in stature, but the music, the love of music, and his talent with the, and he, I don't think he read music, music sheet. He played everything by ear, and he was just fantastic. See, and the fact that you were able to invite him to your home, and he would be the center of attraction, he'd be the entertainment. After I graduated from college and went to work, and I met up with John Conley, we start talking, and the first thing we said, let's go to lunch with Father Tom, and we had lunch with maybe five of us, six of us, so we had a good time. So when we broke up, we said, well, let's do it again next year. Get the same guys that started it, but we'll add a couple more. Crowd started getting a little bigger, so we did that, and he says, let's do it the following year. So that's what we did. We repeated it at different places as the crowd grew, and we did it by word of mouth. And finally, we started to get real, really fancy. And we said, well, let's send out some invitations the next year. And that's when the crowd started to come in. So we had to move to maybe four or five different venues. And we went from the early days, moving around, and we settled into the Irish Club in Fairfield. We had continual luncheons without any interruptions since the day we met that first day at Pajeras.
When they first started at prep, Father Murphy was the only Latin teacher. So all the people, ones that I were familiar with, that graduated in 1946, had Father Murphy for Latin. So for lack of a better name, they would call themselves Father Murphy's Latin Scholars. And then when Father Murphy passed away, they decided to raise some money and name the music room in Father Murphy's name. At one time, the recreation or the requirements to be a Latin scholar was you had to have flunked the Latin at least once. We even had Latin scholars who never took Latin, and we hope that tradition continues.
That was the first question I asked Emo when he asked me to join. He said, I didn't take one class of Latin that fresh. One of the great things about the organization, the Latin scholars that these gentlemen have set up, is that you get to go to the luncheon that they create every year, reminisce with some of your old friends, talk about the old times like you're mentioning right now. So it's a great, simple environment to meet your friends and meet some of the older gentlemen, listen to some of the stories that they have about the school.
As I've associated with other groups in the area, and they have faltered and had to even close up because they were unable to attract the younger generation to join them. It was good news to hear what Joe said. We're doing pretty good with this, keeping the tradition going.
Yeah, the Wee feels that anything that we contribute is a bonus. Because the idea was to get together and have camaraderie with your brother graduates. And if we raise some significant funds, give them to Fairfield Prep. And it's nice to put them in Father Murphy's name. And if I ever meet anybody, the youngest students from Fairfield Prep, I say, you walk in that front door every day. I want you to go out there and take a look. There's a statue out there, a plaque. And Father Murphy's picture is on there. And there's a lot of people that graduated in the 40s and 50s that made sure that that plaque wasn't destroyed when they made additions here. And hopefully he'll be there forever, and his memory will be there forever.
I would say that the Latin scholars, to me, are like the heart and soul of Fairfield Prep. If you really spend any time with, some of the gentlemen that are here today, or come to the Latin scholars and listen to some of the stories, it's really what prep's all about.